This is a video tutorial on how to set up AWS Athena so that you can query the end-use saving shapes dataset on your own using standard SQL queries. So here we have the datasets page on the RESDoc website. A similar page on the Comstock website is available. And we will be setting up one of these datasets to be connected to our own SQL query engine. So the way we do that is by going to our AWS account. So you'll need an AWS account, which you can set up directly with them, and you'll log into the console like this, and you'll see a screen very similar to this. You also need the key and the secret key that comes along with your account. Just follow the AWS documentation for how to set that up. So the first thing we'll do to set up our data connection to the end-use saving shapes data in the OD data lake is we need to go to a service called AWS Glue. And the best way to find it, if you haven't been there before, is to go to the search box here and just type in Glue. So you click Glue right there. And the first thing we'll need to do is set up a database. I've done that here, so you just click Add Database and give it a name. I called it ESS OD. Then you click Create Database. I've already done that, so we can see that it exists right here, and we don't have any tables in it. So the next step is that we'll want to add tables to that database with the data from the data lake. And the way we do that is we have to set up a crawler, which goes and kind of looks through the data and brings it in as a table. So we go to crawlers here. And first thing we'll do to do that is to say create crawler over here. And we just got to give this a name. So I'm going to call this EUSS res. We're going to load the 2018 data in it. And this is the. Yeah, we'll just call it that. And then the next step, you'll ask if it is already mapped to glue tables. It is not. And the next thing you need to do is add a data source. So data sources are on S3. You'll say it is in a different account and it's a publicly available S3 data set. So yeah, it's not going to be in your account, it's going to be in a different account. One of the things that is really helpful for this process of finding the right place to load your S3 data from is to use an S3 browser tool. I use one called CyberDuck. There's also one out there called WinSCP, but I'll demo how to do it in CyberDuck. So if we go here, we'll see I already have the data lake set up. What you'll need to do to set that up for yourself is you go and click a little plus here to create a new bookmark. I'm just going to click the pencil here to edit this bookmark and show you kind of how to fill that out. So you click the plus, and then you'll go to the dataset type, click Amazon S3, and this is where you'll need that key and the secret key. You'll just paste those right in there and save them. And then the important thing here is you need to set the path. Otherwise, it will only show you S3 data that's in your account, but you want to have it look for things in the OD data lake. So in here, you just need to enter this slash OD data lake slash NRLPDS building stock. And that will take you to the right place in S3 so that you can view the data. So once you get all that bookmark saved, you just go and double click on it, and it will open the data lake. And go to end use profiles for building stock 2022. And we have our three data sets here. I think I said I was going to do the 2018, the AMY 2018, so we'll just double click on that to open it. And so yeah, this is just basically a file viewer for S3 data. If you want to download any of this, you just drag it in onto your computer and it will download. Be careful of some of these folders, they're really large. But you can do it that way. So we'll need to copy data, or we'll need to copy S3 locations from two places to load it into AWS. The first one is this metadata folder here, which has all of the kind of baseline and upgrades. So this includes the building characteristics and the annual energy use for those for each of the buildings and for each of the upgrades. And that gets imported as one table. So we'll right click on that and say copy URL S3 URL. And then we can go back to our crawler thing here and just paste that in. So that's for the metadata. Leave it on crawl all subfolders and sample only. This one makes it run a lot faster. If you say sample only a subset of files, just put one in there. All the files have the same format, so you really don't need to crawl all the files, and this just makes it run a lot faster. So we'll add that data source, and that is the metadata. And then we also want to add the time series data. So add another data source. Say it's in a different account. We'll go back to our CyberDuck app. And the one we're interested in here is this time series individual buildings. And then it's kind of sorted out by state. So you want to click this by state folder and say copy URL, select S3 URL on that. And that will copy that path. You can just paste that in there. So you get time series individual buildings by state. And that will help get it partitioned the right way. Same thing, sample only a subset, one file in each folder, and then add the data source. So you'll see we have those two data sources there, the metadata and the time series. Go on to the next. For this, you'll generally just want to choose the default Glue service role. If you don't have that already, you can create it here. There's documentation on AWS on how to do that. But yeah, just kind of whatever the default settings are here. We'll say next. And this is where you choose the database you created earlier. So we'll choose ESS OD. And here you want to add a prefix. So this is kind of what the prefix to all your tables will be. So if you load multiple data sets into the same database, this is helpful to differentiate them. So I believe we called this one ResDoc AMY 2018 release one. So it's 2018 one. Put an extra underscore on the end so that when it gets concatenated with the rest of the table name. So that should be ready to go. Click next, and this is kind of review everything. Looks good. So we create the crawler. And so now the next thing we need to do is run the crawler. So let's search for it here. USS Res 2018. Let's check the box there and say run. And so this will take a few minutes and we'll come back. Okay, so it's been a few minutes since I started that crawler, and we come back into our AWS Glue console here, and we can go see the data tables that the crawler created. So if you go to databases, click on your database, USS OD, you'll see that there are now two tables. Here, this data. The first thing we'll need to do is we do need to fix the time series table, which is this one that says by state. That only catches the last thing. So this is the time series table. We'll need to fix one of the columns in it so that we can join it with the other. So yeah, let me show you how to do that. You go to your table here, you click on it. You'll see the table overview. You can see which columns it has. And come up here to the right-hand side and say Edit Schema. So you'll see here that we have all of these energy columns. And for that. And the one thing we do need to do is update this upgrade column from a string to an integer. So we do that by just clicking the checkbox, say edit, name upgrade, data type. We'll just pick int. just say save as new table version. And now when you go to the schema there, it's right at the very end. So click on that last one, you can see that that is an integer. And the reason that is important is because it allows us to join with the other table, which is our metadata table, which has that column also as an integer, so allows them to join successfully in the database. So yeah, now we can show you how to access the data through Athena. So now we have this data loaded into Glue. We go to our search box here and type in Athena and click on that, and then we'll open what looks like a database viewer. And you can go to your database over here, select the one you just created. You can see your tables and the columns that are in them. And probably the easiest way to see what's in there is to just say, click on these right three dots here and say preview the table. Then it'll query and show you the first 10 rows. Generally speaking, you don't want to see all of the rows because there's going to be very many of them, more than would successfully query and show here. So yeah, you can see we have information about each building, you know, details about the characteristics, climate zone, ceiling fan efficiency, where it is, type of clothes washer, so on and so forth. All the rest dot characteristics you're used to seeing. And then at the end here, there are the outputs about each end use, energy consumption intensity, so it's divided by square foot. And finally here you have the building ID and this upgrade. So that allows you to join it with another table, namely this time series table. Likewise, you can see in the time series table for each building, if we preview that one, we can see that there is, you know, timestamp and energy use for each of the end uses and the upgrade and building ID. So if you join on those two columns, you can see what, you know, like a aggregate profile is for buildings based on a certain characteristic. So we'll provide you some queries on how to do that. But that's the general gist of it. You can write more complicated queries here and download the results. And this allows you to query the terabytes of data that are there.